everybody. I am hoping if I don't wear a microphone today, maybe I won't have issues with the voice cutting in and out. I'm not sure if that was the issue or not. When I play back my camera on my computer, straight from the camera, it does beautifully. It may be the Movie Maker, which is kind of the old system that I use to edit my videos. That might be what is causing the lines around my hands, because it doesn't show up in the original format. So we're checking on that. We're going to try to figure it out hopefully here very soon. So I've got two 12-inch paintings that I did maybe 2 days ago, maybe three, I forget. And I sold them right away on Facebook when I posted them on my Facebook page. And I've got to seal them. And I do not wait for weeks, because my paintings dry in 24 hours. I don't put paint on super thick. And I use as little silicone or whatever. And on these, I used coconut milk, the OGX coconut milk. And with that, I use even less than I do with the silicone, because the OGX coconut milk gives nice, big, juicy cells if you don't put too much in, or if you don't stir it a whole lot. So, I don't even see any residue, but I'm going to show you how I clean them off. So I have one dry paper towel. I have a wet paper towel for rinsing it off, and I have one that I put Dawn dish liquid on. So I just take this and go around really well. And I do keep the push pins on the back until after they're sealed, so you can still keep them raised up and you don't put your painting down and risk getting the varnish stuck on the bottom of the painting. So there's that one. A little bit more. And I don't get it all bubbly and sudsy and soapy and all that, because I don't use that much silicone to warrant getting it all soaked up and fuzzy. Foamy. Soapy. I said fuzzy. Fuzzy wouldn't be the word. Okay, now I'm going to use my damp paper towel that has no soap on it, and just wipe it down good. And you can also sprinkle cornstarch first on your painting to get rid of any oily residue before you do it with the soap part. If you want to sprinkle cornstarch, you can do that as well. Some people even use alcohol to wipe down their paintings, so you can even do that as well. Then you dry them off very well. And these canvases are actually not super tight. So I'm also, when I'm done, I'm going to spray the back of them with water. You spray them down really good with a spray bottle with water and let them dry overnight, and they'll be nice and tight. And you can do that a couple of times if you need to. So when I was waiting for these to dry, I'm always really picky and nosy, and I was with this one here. And so yeah, there's a spot here where I stuck my finger in it. So I've got me some paint here, and it's not quite black. So I put another color into my black. It's kind of like a reddish black. And I'm gonna go over this just with a little bit of paint to touch it up. The only thing about this is, you know, it won't be like super, super smooth like it is when you do a pour. But after I have the polyurethane on it, it will not show up. And I noticed a white spot here. So this is the time, if you want to do any touch-ups, that you can do them before you actually seal them. And this is, you know, more so on darker paintings than on lighter paintings. You know, if you've got a white background or white in your colors, it won't show up so much. But if you've got a dark color and it's missing like a little bit of black or whatever, this is the time to touch things up before that varnish goes on. Corners especially. Let these dry really well. I don't like, some people say they use alcohol. I don't like using alcohol because it lifts your paint off. So I don't recommend alcohol. So these were Arteza paints, and that is metallic gold there here at the top. Sometimes in the pictures it just doesn't do it justice as far as showing. In the picture it almost looks like a whitish cream color, but it's really metallic gold. And I'm going to use what I prefer the most, is Liquitex High Gloss Varnish. It's my go-to. And the last one I did, I put a little too much varnish on and I just scrubbed it around and it leveled out and I didn't even have to put another coat on. But like here where I touched up the paint, the Arteza is a premium paint, and with the Oetrol, well, I think I use Floetrol with this, it leaves a sheen. There is a sheen, you can see that. But like here where I added the paint, it was just standard acrylic paint. You can see in the reflection there, it's dull looking. So this does leave a sheen, like a, what I call a satin finish. And you can get by with not putting gloss over your paintings if you don't want to. But when you add gloss, it just gives it another layer of depth, which really brings out that color. And that's why I especially do it with any darker colors. It makes those dark colors really pop. I'm just gonna make sure my brush that I've had in the bag for a while. This has varnish on it. It's not wet from water, it has varnish. And what I do is I use it over and over again. I do not rinse it. I put it straight back into my bag and close it up and I keep it for a few weeks and it does really well that way. So what I do is I put down a generous amount of varnish. And it has a milky, almost bluish kind of cast to it. And I scrub it around on the first coat. I scrub it around. And you also look at the reflection of the light in your varnish as you do it to make sure you're covering every bit of the canvas. Now the last one I did, I scrubbed it around and it worked perfectly. It was also one that did not have any silicone or coconut milk or anything in it. And that worked, but see, I can tell right now on the first coat, this one, it separates a little bit. It might work out okay. I'm gonna keep scrubbing it while it's like super wet. Liquitex stays wet a little bit longer than like the polyacrylic from Minwax. So you have just a little bit more time with Liquitex to work with it. And it's actually doing pretty well. You can see if there's an area that wants to separate, you just kind of keep going over it. But all I'm doing is going in a circular pattern. And as it sits there for a few minutes, it levels itself out, which is really the cool part. And then I just make sure to go around the edges whoever, you know, whoever purchases this, my customer that's already purchased this, I don't know if she's going to frame these or not, but, you know, I get them ready so that if she does not want to frame them, the edges are painted and sealed and it will look good, framed or not framed. So right now that looks pretty good. I'm going to do a painting right after this. It's going to take me a little while. And when I'm finished with it, I will come back and we'll look at these paintings and see how they dry. So here I am again, scrubbing it around in circles. And that first coat is always going to kind of separate a little bit after you've used silicone or coconut milk. I always have that issue on the first coat. But I'm just going to keep working around. But like I said, I have a generous amount on here. I don't have just a little bit. So it's like really wet with varnish. Make sure to get all your edges and corners. So this one is, it's trying to separate a little bit more. The other way I do it is after you circle around, then you just go across it in one direction only. You don't crisscross or do anything different than just go in one direction. And this one apparently had some, you know, more silicone than the other one because it's not, I'm actually going to scrub it in a little bit more. It's a really thick coat. Now, if this were a super large canvas, I would not have time to do all this with a super large canvas because it would start tacking up and drying on you and you wouldn't have time to play with it like you do on a smaller canvas. This is also why I do not spray canvases because I don't have much luck with spray paint. It kind of makes it blotchy looking in my opinion. So that's why I like to put the varnish on myself. I have way better control. So this one is separating a little bit. You get these little tiny craters. And that's okay because what I'll do is I'll come back with that second coat and those craters will go away. So just making sure I get my edges and corners. And where I patched the color in, you can't even tell that I did it, which is great. So, I think that's it. I'm going to put my brush back in my bag. I'm not rinsing it. And I'm sealing up the bag nice and tight. And I'm going to move these out of the way. That is one of my subscribers asked if I would please show how to do wiring on the back of a canvas. So this is like just a little quick demonstration. This is a painting I called Celebration. So to me, it's oriented where it goes upward and outward. So I think of this as the top of the canvas here. So this is a 12-inch canvas. Rule of thumb is to not go more than a third down on your canvas. So if your length of canvas is 12 inches, then that would be 4 inches. If the length of the canvas is 36 inches, that would be 12. So you just divide your length by 3. And for 12, it's 4 inches. So I take my ruler and I go from the top of the canvas and mark. I put the mark on the inside of the wood, so the same here, 4 inches. And instead of putting the little screws that go in here, I don't put them on the back, I put them on the inside of the wood. That way they don't stick out and your canvas can hang flush to the wall. So I just screw these little, I think they're called eyes, E-Y-E-S, eyes. They have a loop on the end and a screw. And if it, these are smaller ones, so I'm just doing it with my hands, but like if you have bigger ones, you can even start the hole with a small nail to give it a starting point. And then it's easier to screw in. So I just take that dot that I marked with my black pen, and that's where I start screwing it in. Whoops. Drop it in, just make sure you can get it out. Get a little nail. And you start that little hole right there. And then, this is like super close to the canvas, that's why I'm having a hard time getting it started. Screwing in the second one. And then your wire needs to go through this loop and through this loop. And then you give yourself a little hanging space. But what I do is I make sure the hanging space is below that wood piece. So that, like I said, it can hang flush to the wall. So I just look for that, that amount of space. And so I bend my wire up on either side. So when you do the second side, you hold that wire nice and tight, and then you just twist it around. And you just wrap your wire. This is actually thicker wire. It's made, it's a heavier gauge wire, and it's made to hang, you know, heavier weight than this little painting, but this is what I just had to show you with this. And it's got a plastic coating on it, which makes it nice, because sometimes this wire gets kind of sharp and it can poke you. So I wrap my wire around and just come up a little ways, and that way you know that it's, that wire's not going anywhere. Do it on the other side just the same way. You just twist it around the main wire. I hope you can see that. So I'm just twisting it around. So it's nice and tight there. Then these are like, they've got little pinchers on the end, but they also cut wires. So you have wire cutters, and you just take it and squeeze. And cut the wire off on the end. So that it looks like this. So it's just wire that's wrapped around the other wire on either end. And when you pull it up, it goes under the edge of the wood. So that way when somebody hangs it on the wall, it will hang flush to the wall. And that's how I wire a picture. So I did my larger painting. Coming back to the two paintings that I put the Liquitex High Gloss Varnish on. And here is one coat. And I am pretty satisfied with that. One of them I did in a circular fashion, one I did in a straight fashion, and both of them look identical. You cannot tell which one I did in the circular fashion and which one I didn't. This was one coat of the Liquitex High Gloss Varnish, and they are good to go. So if I were to do a second coat, if I went this way the first time, on the second coat I go this way. Then I wait a few hours and then I do another coat and I go that way. But every time you use your sponge brush from your bag and you do not rinse it out and you put it back into the bag so that that sponge brush stays saturated with the varnish and it does an excellent job of coverage. So that's the way I finish my canvases.